Solve using the substitution method. System 1. 5x plus 3y equals 1 and 5 over 3x plus y equals negative 7. When we are asked to use the substitution method, we basically trying to isolate a variable and then plugging in that value for the variable that we isolated in the other equation. So in our example, what I see is that the y is already by itself or has a coefficient of 1, which is good. So I'm going to solve the second equation for y. Subtracting 5 over 3x from both sides . So y is by itself, and that equals to negative 5 over 3x minus 7. Remember, these two are not like terms, so you cannot combine them. So now I'm taking all this, because this is what equals y, and I'm going to plug this into the first equation for the y value. So we have 5x plus 3, and for y we have negative 5 over 3x minus 7. Then we continue with the equation equals 1. So now, in the next step, we should get rid of this parentheses by using distributive property. And even though there is a fraction involved, it's going to be an easy step to eliminate this fraction. We can put the 3 as a fraction as well by putting it over 1 and then just using distributive property. So 5x plus, and now as you can see, when you're multiplying fraction, you can use cross canceling the fraction, so the 3 on top and the 3 in the bottom cancel out, and you are left with basically negative 5x. And then again, 3 times negative 7 gives me a negative 21 equals 1. Now 5x minus 5x is 0, and we are left with negative 21 is equal to 1. That is not a true statement, because negative 21 is actually not equal to 1. Therefore, this system, we have no solution. No solution means when you visualize those two equations as lines, this means that they are parallel. So they never cross, there is no intersection point, and therefore there is no solution when solving the system.